Worlds, one planet. The year is 2250. The human race has slowly devoured all natural resources. The Earth has had to divide, and all that is left is a wasteland. Humans have seen this coming for quite some time, and have found another planet with some stable resources to relocate their entire population to, as well as the means to get there. Upon the humans' arrival to their new planet, similar to Earth, but filled with new, strange creatures, plants, and other aspects, they realize they are not the only intelligence on this new planet. Aliens have also landed on the planet and are beginning to make the new habitat their home as well. After experiencing the similar tragedy of losing their planet, after much debate, the humans and aliens face the reality that they must share this new planet and learn to live with one another. During this new journey presented to both races, not only must they learn to coexist in harmony together, putting their physical differences aside, but they also must conquer the challenges they have faced with this new planet, filled with enlightening, strange, and sometimes even dangerous mysteries. Ellie is an energetic 15-year-old girl who loves to try and make the world around her a better place. She's always trying to make people laugh and create new friends. She's usually well-behaved, but she'll deviate from the rules if she has to, but she believes it is the right thing to do. Ellie is a natural-born leader. She's confident, intelligent, and willing to make tough decisions if necessary. Because of this, Ellie has a unique ability to manage her peers very well, and help guide them to solve problems that may arise. When making an ethical decision, Ellie tends to use the moral rights approach. Bailey is another 15-year-old girl who happens to be Ellie's best friend. While not quite as outgoing as Ellie, she still has much of the same core values. She believes in using the moral rights approach when making ethical decisions, and she enjoys making others happy because she is somewhat shy. She cannot be the leader that Ellie can, but her intelligence and kind heart help her contribute greatly to group decision making. Fred is Ellie's father, and he is truly a family man. He would do anything if it meant helping his family. He doesn't enjoy taking charge, but he will if the situation calls for it. Fred loves stability, and he is not good at managing change. Fred believes that change only occurs if things have gone wrong, but he's Leslie is Ellie's mother. She is a quiet character, and she does not have good leadership or management qualities. She usually tries to stay out of the way and not disturb anybody. She hardly ever exhibits intuitive decision-making. She instead prefers to research and ponder a decision as much as possible, ignoring her gut instinct. Cal is a very curious 15-year-old alien boy. He is at first confused by the humans who come to inhabit his homeland, but he eventually grows to like them. He even ends up befriending one of them, Ellie. Because of this, he becomes a strong proponent of humans and aliens working together. He believes that globalization between the two peoples will benefit them both. James is the best friend of Cal. He is not a huge fan of the humans coming to his homeland, but he doesn't care enough to let it bother him too much. He's very laid back and always joking around. He's very susceptible to group thinking because he's usually too lazy to try and create new ideas of his own. Tim is Cal's father, and he does not approve of the humans entering his homeland. His land has been free of humans for his whole life, and it has worked out just fine, so he believes that integration will cause issues. Tim's management style with his family and with others tends to be borderline authoritarian. He likes to lay down strict ground rules and doesn't want others to contradict his beliefs or commands. Holly is Cal's mother. She is very different than her husband Tim. She tends to be warm and accepting while welcoming the humans to her homeland. Her main concern, however, is for her son. She is always planning and organizing for Cal. She loves him very much and wants him to be as happy and successful as possible. George is the designated leader of the group of humans who have decided to travel to the new planet. He is stoic, charming, and willing to lead. While he can be close-minded towards the aliens at times, he means no ill will, as he is just trying to provide for his people. He serves as mostly a figurehead role to the humans. He gives them a charismatic leader to look up to, and he motivates them to do their jobs with grandeur, public speeches. He has a wife named Sally. Sal is the president of the alien people who, like George, leave them in mostly a figurehead role. However, young men below him, such as Tim, who do most of the real leading and managing. Sal does not like the idea of the humans coming to his homeland, but he is not quite as strongly against it as Tim. He has a wife named Allie. His name is often the butt of jokes by some of the humans and even aliens. George, Sal, and Tim all come together to start forming objectives and plans for the new society. Even though Tim and Sal are not happy with the position they are in, they have realized with the encouragement of their wives that they must put their differences with the humans aside and do what's best for the newly integrated community. Tim logically decides that they should create a SWOT analysis for the new community to identify their strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. Doing this will help them identify the aspects they need to work on the most. Upon completing the SWOT analysis, the three men realize one of the first big hurdles the community will have to overcome is bringing everyone together as one unit to reach a mutually desired goal. One of the first strategic goals they set is to attempt to bring the community together and begin forming bonds. George proposes the first step to this is creating an uplifting and promising mission statement so the people will be able to see that they all have the same goal in the end, a safe, successful, and happy community. After establishing a mission statement, the three men begin planning a large community event filled with the games designed to help the people learn to work and operate together. It will also help them get to know each other in a friendly environment. After agreeing upon hosting an event to try and bring the alien people and humans together, George and Sal both go back to their people with the news. Many people are happy about an attempt to bring the two groups together to form a peaceful environment, but there are also nervous feelings about all of this. The two leaders both have to bring about the news in a way to make their people excited about the opportunity and keep the peace between the two as long as they can. Leaders have to know how to keep their groups under control and manage any problems that the team may think of or face along the way. George George and Sal are beginning to realize this. Both leaders have just brought the good news to their people. Meanwhile, at their village, Ellie and her friend Bailey are telling Ellie's father, Fred, that they do not have enough food. Fred decides to let Ellie and Bailey go into the wild to find some food, but Ellie and Bailey are worried about how to find food in the new and strange environment. Fred and Ellie decide to plan a strategy that focuses on energy, resources, strengthening operations, and ensuring that people are working towards common goals. The first step is to make sure the young girls understand that the current internal and external environment are different. Second, Fred tells Ellie and Bailey they need a plan for every situation that may come up. Third, Fred makes some operational planning devices for the children. The last step is to make sure when the children are back, they give Fred some feedback. Once Ellie and Bailey find food, they will know how to find it in the future. Will the community be able to come together, put differences aside, and build a new world so they can survive? Tune in to next week's episode to find out.